turn on the bedroom light. Okay. Turn off the bedroom light.
Hey, what's up guys? This is Anurag back with another video. And in this video, I will show you the unboxing and the installation of the Sonoff T0EU TX series Wi-Fi wall touch light switch. So using this device, you can control your normal lights using your mobile, remote or artificial intelligence like Google Home or Amazon Alexa. So without wasting any more time, let's begin with the video. Now talking about this device, I bought this device from Bangkok.com around 1300 to 1400 Indian rupees. You can get this device from Indian website as well, but prices will be on higher side. I have ordered total of 7 devices, 3 2 gang and 4 3 gang devices to replace my all light controlling switchboards with this touch panel. All the Best Buy links will be provided in the description box below. So first let's start with the unboxing part. As you can see, the box will look like this. I have ordered this device in 3 gang, but it is available in 1 and 2 gang as well, depending on how many devices you want to connect. Also, I have ordered T0 version, that is without radio frequency support. That means you can't use your RF remote to operate this device. If you want RF support, then you can go ahead with T2 versions. So now let's open the box. After opening up the box, you will first see the user manual. Why? I mean, who reads this? Anyway, after that, you will see the actual device. It is in white color, but you can opt in black as well. So now, let's keep this aside. We'll see what else we'll get inside the box. Next, you will get two screws for mounting this device on your 3x3 inch surface box or a concealed box. Now, we'll see the closer look at this device. On the top, you will see 3 touch blue backlight buttons as it is a 3 channel switch. Then on the back side, you can see its specification. It can accept input voltage of 100 to 200 volt and output voltage 100 to 240 volt at 3 amp max. That means it can give max 1 amp per device. That's why you can connect only small appliances like light, exhaust fan and your ceiling fan. You can't connect this to a socket and connect a big appliances like an electric kettle or an AC. For those purpose, you can buy their separate products that I will list in the description box. Next, if I talk about ports, it has one live wire and one neutral wire port, that is a ground wire port to power this device. And then you have 3 live wire ports to connect your appliances. And yes, you will need a neutral or a ground wire in your existing switchboard. If you don't have a neutral or ground wire, then you will need to get help from an electrician to add a neutral wire in that switchboard. Now let me open this device to show you where to put those screws. And to open it, you have to create a gap by pulling this, as there is no proper notch to open this. And finally, after a couple of attempts, I am able to open this device. And here you can see this PCB, and then you can see the 4 screw holes. Here, as per your installation orientation, you have to put 2 screws. Now let's see how to install this device. As per this diagram, where it says N in, there your neutral wire will go. Where it says L in, there your live wire will go. Then there are 3 output ports where you can connect your actual lights, and that's it. Now you have seen the wiring diagram, we can do the actual installation. But I will not recommend you to do this by your own unless you are an expert. Now after that quick disclaimer, you can turn off our mains connection or we can individually turn on the MCB that goes to the switchboard. But I will recommend you to switch off your all MCBs to be on a safer side. Once that done, you'll need to remove your existing switchboard. In my case, it is a concealed switchboard. So first, I'm removing the front cover. Underneath that, you can see two screws that are holding this device. Once those removed, you can see all the wires. Now you can mark all the output wires that goes to the appliances. In my case, it is one exhaust fan and two LED lights. After marking is done, I have removed all the connected wires. And as I told you, this requires a neutral or a ground wire. In my case, I didn't have any neutral wire in my switchboard, but besides that, I had one socket, so I have extended one ground wire from that socket. Then I have installed a live wire. Rest of the three output wires that goes to the appliances. And to test that it works or not, I have turned on my mains connection, and as you can see, all it is working now. Then again I turned off my mains connection, and then I have completed this installation by putting two screws. Then putting back the front cover. Then you can connect this device to a Wi-Fi by holding any touch switch for a 3 second. Once you are in pairing mode, you can download and open the Evlink app, and then you can go to quick pairing. Here you can enter your Wi-Fi username and password. Then it will find this device and connect to that device. Once the device is added, you can control your connected device through this mobile application. And if you want to link this device to your Amazon Alexa or Google Home account, then you can follow some simple steps provided in the Evlink app in the profile section. Now I will quickly show you how I replace my rest of the switchboards. Thank you. that's pretty much it for this video. If you like this video, then don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to see more videos on home automation. This has been Anura, and I will see you guys later.